Do you know how spironolactone works as a potassium-sparing diuretic? Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will see mechanism of action of spironolactone. Let's get started. First, relevant physiology of tubular processing at collecting duct. This is nephron. This is collecting duct. This is principal cell. This is sodium-potassium ATPase pump at the basolateral membrane. And here we have sodium channel and potassium channel at the apical membrane. As we have seen in video of sodium reabsorption, sodium enters through sodium channel into the cell and is extruded by sodium potassium ATPase pump into the interstitium. As sodium is positively charged ion, its removal from lumen makes the lumen electron negative. This drives diffusion of potassium from cell into the lumen. This potassium is eventually excreted. Now, sodium reabsorption over here is regulated by aldosterone. It's a hormone released from adrenal cortex. Principal cells have mineralocorticoid receptors in cytoplasm. Aldosterone binds with this receptor and makes aldosterone receptor complex. This complex then goes into the nucleus. Here it induces transcription leading to synthesis of some mRNAs. These mRNAs are then translated to produce several proteins. These proteins are called aldosterone-induced proteins. They include sodium potassium ATPase pump and epithelial sodium channels. Also, there are other proteins that increase availability of these transport proteins on the membrane and their activity as well. Thus, under influence of aldosterone, sodium reabsorption is increased. This makes lumen even more electronegative, which in turn increases potassium secretion. So this was physiology part. Now let's bring in spironolactone. It's a synthetic steroid. It binds with mineralocorticoid receptor and competitively inhibit binding of aldosterone with the receptor. So effect of aldosterone is decreased. Means no synthesis of aldosterone-induced proteins. So sodium reabsorption is decreased, which produces diuretic action of spironolactone. See, due to decreased reabsorption of sodium, lumen becomes less electronegative now. This decreases potassium secretion, thus preventing its loss in urine. And this is how spironolactone works as a potassium-sparing diuretic. That's it, friends. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.